Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Today, early morning, I went to Oxford to attend a forum on spirituality at St. Saviour, which is Orthodox Church. And they bring in Orthodox priest from different countries, and so I met a couple of priests from Russia, St. Petersburg. They gave me their card, you know, I misplaced it, but I gave them my book, you know, on One God, One Faith, and hope they will write me. Never mind, you know, as God wishes, so it happens. So there were quite a great number of people over there, and it was overflowing. Few people were sitting in the porch outside the room. And so when I went there, this lecturer, who was very Reverend Dr. Nicholas V. Sakharov, B.A., Ph.D., a priest monk at the Monastery of St. John the Baptist, Tolleshunt Knights, Essex. And he was speaking on the Archimandrite Sophrony, his grand uncle. Oh, I see. As well as numerous articles, his Oxford PhD degree research on this topic was published by SVS Press. It's all in description. So he was a grandson of a monk, you know, and who was at St. John the Baptist. And I had a chance to ask him a question, and that was, you know, that in Jesus, there's neither male nor female, nor a Jew nor a Gentile, because it's not our physical self that is involved in Jesus, this physical self, but our soul. And soul has no color, no gender, male or female. Then I asked him, you know, at Mount Athos in Greece, why do the monk do not allow women on the Mount Athos? They are only men allowed, you know. So that means those monks over there, they do not know that in Jesus, our supernatural self, soul, is concerned, and not the natural self. This is natural self. In nature, we are male and female. And the natural self, you need a priest, which was John the Baptist, was an ideal priest who was teaching the moral laws. So to natural self, moral law applies, not to the spiritual. But in the St. John the Baptist monastery, I went there a couple of times, and almost 2 years. And there are a lot of women there too. And they are monks and women, you know, both living there. Now, there is too much blindness. This monastery was planted by the grandfather of this young man, who is a PhD, BA PhD, and there was Metropolitan Anthony of Sorozo, who died, and he did not approve this Father Sophrony to open a monastery, but he did it against his wishes. Now, there are many things they spoke about the two, and they spoke that Metropolitan Anthony was very strong opinion of his own, so he won't budge, and he will give his own opinion and all that. However, the main point I want to bring over here is simple. John the Baptist, he was a witness to the light, but not the light. He was moon, and light is sun. So, let's see if I can find my thing. Yeah, here it is, and this is a Christ Jesus, sun, primary source of light, and there is the Christ Jesus, and there is the John the Baptist, moon, witness to the light, but not the light. This light, you get it from sun, when you do not love money, mammon, then you get it. Now, John the Baptist, as you know, he took to wilderness. So, he was not interested in mammon, and so was Christ Jesus. Both, they were not hireling of mammon. They were free of mammon. John the Baptist, being a moon, he reflected the moonlight. So that is the moral laws which apply to our physical body. This is moon. Inside us is of sun, soul. So John the Baptist, he was not a saint. He was an angel. Angels are those who are perfect in the moral laws, who are the teachers of the moral laws. If they are perfect, they are angels. Like Stephen, the first administrator of the Church of God, he was not a saint. He was an angel. And these people who preached the gospel, they were roving preachers. And they were apostles. So most of the apostles after Jesus, they were Gentile. There were, of course, the apostles which Jesus had picked them, you come. And he employed them in the vineyard of our Father, which has a narrow gate. So, what happened then? Soon after the death of the apostles, the first one, John, Peter, Christ Jesus, Saint James the Just, and Angel Stephen, when they were killed, afterward, the Jewish people, they jumped over the wall and entered into the church. When they entered the church, the apostles they bring in the Torah with them, and Torah, it poisoned the church. Jewish leaven poisoned the church, so people were happily reading Torah. So when the apostles wanted to come and deliver the gospel, the bishops said, look, they are reading Torah, they are happy. We don't need a gospel. Go away. So they pushed the apostles out. And when they got Roman in their hands, they killed them by putting them before the animals. So light came among his own, the chosen people. They loved darkness. And that is how they created darkness. So John the Baptist, he was angel of Israel, or prophet Elijah. He was not a saint. So people who call him saint, they have this monastery, Saint John the Baptist, and I went there. They put a hollow around his head, which was golden. Gold represents sun. So they made him a saint. And I told the over there monk, look, this is wrong, John the Baptist was a witness to the light, he is moon, and moon is silver, not gold. You can see it, gold, and it should be a silver, it's wrong, He said, they did not want to listen to me. What they were doing is true, and they were engaged in praying and fasting. And I told them, praying and fasting, it is antichrist. Because in Jesus, our Father is no more in heaven. That Father in heaven, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That is Yahweh, the creator of male and female, which is the Jewish Father, Jewish God, Yahweh. Not New Testament God, which is spirit. And our Father, God, is in the temple of God, which is this one. He lives in this temple, not up in the heaven anymore. We are no more alienated from God as the Yahweh was alienated by the rabbi, but Christ Jesus, through his word, has united us with our Father. So our Father and we are one. He knows the matters of our heart before they come on our lip. So in Jesus we don't say prayer. Prayer was out ritual of the Old Testament. We have been moved into new house, new utensils, everything new. We don't need old utensils. All the old rituals are of Antichrist. So if you bring them in to the new house, you are bringing the Jewish leaven into the church, a Jewish leaven into your house, which is forbidden by Christ Jesus. Do not bring Jewish leaven into the church of God. So that is the thing, the people are doing things without thinking. And when I contradict them, they are not happy. So these monks and other people put on these clothing, robes, and these robes are a priest. Royal priests don't need these robes. Because in royal priest, we don't need ordination of men. We are ordained by our Father. Unless you are ordained by our Father, you can't preach gospel. So these are antichrist. But you face them, you will see how they will react, because they are in majority. So just think of the time when Jesus came and these people were there, but in a lesser strength, temple priest, village rabbis, they listened to Jesus. But the Jerusalem temple priest and rabbis, they rejected him. because they were full of the old wine of the letters, like these university professors. So the situation is worse now, as predicted in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The arid spirit is the temple priest who was sacked by the sacrifice of Jesus as the Lamb of God. Lamb of God means to get rid of those dog-collared priests. And there you are, they are here today in greater strength, creating darkness. So, never mind. If it is darkness, you know, they will suffer. As it is in God, you know. We do not say what you are doing is wrong. Whatever they will do, they will reap the result accordingly. So it's our duty to point out our views, and if he doesn't like it, it's up to them. The same thing Christ Paul has said, same is written in the holy book of the sixth Ad-Granth, that in each one of us, whether he is doing bad job or good job, holy or evil, the soul of our Father is in him. And our Father is in him, and he give him free will. Do whatever you like, but you will pay reward according to your deeds. If you go by Christ in your heart, Christ is the Son of the Most High God, which is Spirit. If you go by the Christ in your heart, then you will be saved from birth and rebirth cycle. Or you will get salvation, which is resurrection. Otherwise, if you don't go by the Christ and you go by your own will, then you will come into the death and birth cycle. And then you will keep on doing that until you have Christ in your heart again. So Christ appears after so many ages, four ages. There are four ages in the cycle. So when the cycle come again, the dark age come, Christ comes, then he, through gospel, then saves people into the royal kingdom of God. And those who don't care for his gospel and do whatever they like, they reap the reward accordingly. So why should we worry? So that is what I have today. And also I went to Brahma Kumari, where they were celebrating Diwali. I will make a video on that one.